reduced by Professor Giovanni De Gaetano from Pozzilli, Italy. Its higher adherence to Mediterranean diet is associated with lower risk of overall mortality in subjects with cardiovascular disease. Prospective results from the Molisani study.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for inviting me to participate in this press conference. I will describe the results of a study we are running in our institute in Italy, showing that adherence to the Mediterranean diet reduces the risk of overall mortality, not only in the general population, which is already known, but in patients who already suffered a myocardial infarction or a cerebrovascular accident. I have nothing to declare, and also the co-authors of this presentation. It is known that the traditional Mediterranean diet is associated with reduced cardiovascular and cerebrovascular risk, but this conclusion derives mainly from general population studies and have not been investigated deeply as a secondary prevention possibility. You all know that the Mediterranean diet means large intakes of legumes, vegetables, fruits, nuts, cereals, moderate use consumption of fish, olive oil as the main source of fatty acids, and also moderate alcohol consumption, possibly, preferably during meals. This is accompanied by reduced consumption of cheese, yogurt, and especially of meat and poultry. Nothing is forbidden in the Mediterranean diet, but what is important is the amount and the frequency by which you consume these products. The data derive from a large epidemiological study we have started in 2005 in the region where I work, which is called Molise. Molise is here, I must say, very near to the earthquake center which occurred a few days ago, but we had, fortunately, no particular problems. This small region, the people living in these small regions are called the Molisani, but our study is called the Molisani because sani means in Italian healthy. So it is a joke of words, Molisani, to underline that we are more interested in health than in disease. We are more interested in prevention than in cure or diagnosis. We enrolled adults aged 35 years or without any limitation. And these people were extracted from the list of residents in the 30 villages or cities of the region, which were randomized in precedence. So at the end, we collected 25,000 people resident in Molise, and we started a follow-up for cardiovascular, cerebrovascular, and cancer events. Within this population, we found about 1,200,000 individuals who, at the moment of recruitment, had already suffered a cardiovascular or a cerebrovascular event, including coronary artery disease, and cerebrovascular events. We investigated the dietary habits by the EPIC food frequency questionnaire and measured the adherence to the Mediterranean diet by the Trikopoulou score, which includes nine items, nine foods typical of the traditional Mediterranean diet. And following or not following these points, you get or you don't get 1 point in the score. All-cause mortality was assessed by linkage with the offices of the vital statistics of our region, and the statistical analysis were performed according to the best methods available. These are the main results. When we compared people who were poor followers of the Mediterranean diet and had a very low score between 0 and 3, and were our reference group, with people who had a medium adherence, 4-5 points in the score, or with people who followed the Mediterranean diet with a relatively high score from 6 to 9, we found that the mortality hazard risk was significantly reduced, both in the people following at the medium level, but especially in the people who followed faithfully the Mediterranean diet. The reduction in this group was about 38%, which is an important percentage. We, in another way, we also calculated that an increase of 2 points in the score was associated with a reduction of about 20% of the all-cause death. We know the specific causes of that, but the number are too small to make analysis of specific causes of that. So from a statistical point of view, we had to analyze only all-cause mortality, but continuing the follow-up, certainly, unfortunately, I must say, but certainly we will increase the number of events, and so we could also present data not only on all-cause mortality, but also on specific causes of this very hard endpoint, clinical endpoint. We also made a statistical exercise removing from the score one by one the different food, and to see whether the association remained or was decreased or modified. And in fact, what influenced more the effect of the total diet were vegetables, 26 reduction in the association when we removed from the score the consumption of vegetables, and also fish consumption, fruits and nuts, and low consumption of meat and processed meat, and also the use of monounsaturated fats, which means olive oil, made an important contribution. So in conclusion, the traditional Mediterranean diet, as measured by the Greek score, was associated with a significant reduction of all-cause mortality in adults with an history of ischemic cardiocerebrovascular disease, which belonged to a large Mediterranean cohort. The major contributions, as I mentioned, were offered by vegetables, fish, fruits, nuts, and olive oil as a fatty contribution. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Professor Huber.
So unfortunately, we do not know at the moment which kind of causes for mortality are there. But you said you will extend this investigation, because I would be interested. Is it cardiovascular? Is it cancer? And it's not a joke. What happens to patients with their, let's say, psychosomatic or psychological oriented diseases, suicide or so? I would be very interested whether Mediterranean diet is not only positive, or maybe it's positive in all these different opportunities.
Yeah, you are right, but we hope to, if you will invite me in a few years from now again to the ESC, perhaps I will be able to answer your question. But I think that the important point is that people want to know whether they will die or not, independently of the cause. It doesn't matter to patient if they will die of this or that. I tell them, if you follow the Mediterranean diet, you have a reduction of the total mortality, even perhaps by car accident, I don't know, but perhaps. And this is important. It is not important to distinguish between diagnoses. When we shall have the number, we shall also do that.
Okay, let me ask you something. We all know that we will die, so that's not the question. Not the question, we all will die, that's clear. But I assume that you have excluded the effects of smoking cessation, exercise activity, etc., etc. In this,
we adjusted for all the possible variables.
Okay. Now, yes. My question is: do you have any information that the people that is a follower of the Mediterranean diet, it's also the people that is more conscious of the disease, so it stops smoking, exercises? I know that you have excluded that in the statistical analysis, but. Do the people that has a more Mediterranean diet also is more, let's say, good patient in terms of smoking cessation, sport activity, et cetera, et cetera?
Yeah, we adjusted also for smoking in our analysis.
Sure.
What really influences the adherence to Mediterranean diet in our population is the socioeconomic situation. All other possible variables had a very, very little influence. But the socioeconomic condition, the education and the income make a difference, and especially this difference is obvious after 2007, when the economical crisis started. Because before there was no difference between different classes, but after 2007 and 2008, the people entering in the study showed a significant difference according to the socioeconomic condition. Poor people are obliged to follow less the Mediterranean. If you consider a family of four persons, and if you tell them, eat fish twice a week, or eat vegetables, fruit, five portions per day. At half a month, you must stop.
Thank you. Questions, please.
I was a little surprised at the vegetables had the largest effect. Do you think that's restricting, they're getting their calories from that, or getting full? So they're not eating worse foods? And did you adjust for BMI and total caloric intake among these people? Because thinner people might just be doing better, and people who are eating vegetables may be thinner.
Yeah, as I said, this was a statistical exercise, so we don't give too much importance to the fact that removing, let's say, vegetables, the association is reduced by 25%. But we adjusted for body mass index and all other possible variables which would influence. Of course, when we say vegetables, in this analysis, we did not distinguish cooked or raw vegetables. And so the investigation can continue and will go more and more deeper into the effect.
Please.
Chris Smythe from the Times of London. As you said, there's a lot of evidence in terms of primary prevention of the Mediterranean diet. I mean, is there really nothing in terms of this secondary prevention group, or what makes this better in terms of what other research that has been in this secondary prevention group, firstly? And then secondly, what use do you want doctors to make of this? Should they be saying, you know, when they see a patient who's had one of these conditions, you know, here's your statins or whatever, and here's a recipe book as well, and they're, you know, equally important?
I don't know if I, because I could not see you before. You ask whether our data have something to do with the use of statins?
No. The question is whether... What do you want the doctors to do with this information?
Yeah, the doctors should inquire about the dietary habits of the people. Of course, they will continue to prescribe cardiovascular drugs, statins, aspirin, whatever they want, but they cannot look at the drugs as the only way to secondary prevention of cardiovascular disease. Suggestions to follow healthy dietary habits is as important as prescribing drugs. However, there is a practical problem that at least in Italy, in the UK, the National Health Service pays for drugs, but does not pay for vegetables and fruits. So how doctor can say, please don't take statins, which are paid by the state, but consume vegetables, which you should pay? So the government should reduce, for instance, the VAT on items of the Mediterranean diet, and the state should say, okay, I cover your expenses for drugs, and I also contribute to your expenses if you follow the Mediterranean diet.
The first question was about secondary.
Yeah, first question, as you said, there's lots of research in primary prevention on the Mediterranean diet, but I mean, is there really nothing or very little in this secondary prevention group, and how is this different or better than what there is?
Well, this is, if I understand well, this is a secondary prevention study because all patients are cardiovascular patients.
But I'm asking, is there really very little research
right.
in secondary prevention?
The question is whether
we have data on the general population, which apparently have no cardiovascular or cerebrovascular events. And we confirm what is known also from other studies that Mediterranean diet reduced a number of events, including mortality. But the interest was to see whether also in the secondary prevention the mechanism could be confirmed.
And has that not been done before? It's just surprising.
So,
and there is no information before. There is no other study secondary.
To my knowledge, the total mortality as an endpoint has not been studied before.
One second. Yeah. Go ahead.
Hi, Ben Spencer from the Daily Mail in London. 37% is a remarkable reduction in all-cause mortality for CVD. You know, the best statins data, you're looking at kind of 18% according to, you know, European Society of Cardiology data. So this is looking like twice as good. Shouldn't everyone just put away the statins and, you know, as Chris suggested, give out a recipe book?
We cannot compare in terms of percentage reduction of mortality a randomized clinical trial by which statins have been investigated or other cardiovascular drugs with an observational study, an epidemiological study such as the Molisani study, where we did not randomize patients. The patients selected themselves to follow or not to follow Mediterranean diet. So the context is completely different to make a meaningful comparison. The conclusion can be that drugs can be effective in secondary prevention. Mediterranean diet can be effective in secondary prevention. What is better
or if consuming Mediterranean diet, perhaps you can reduce the amount of statins and so reduce the side effects of these drugs, is an interesting question. So I hope to be able to answer in a few years from now.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Yes, I have two questions. I'm writing for American cardiologists. Was this a study in rural Italy, for example, or were the people living in a big city? And would it be generalizable? Would an American cardiologist be able to say that there was a study in Italy and it showed that for secondary prevention, Mediterranean diet was helpful?
When you analyze the consumption of Mediterranean diet and an event such as mortality, the association is statistically universal. It does not depend on if you are in Italy or in the States. Certainly, the way of the Italians consume Mediterranean diet can be different, but it is also different a little bit from Greece, from Spain. So our data show that there is association. We analyzed also in detail which components could contribute to the association. I would suggest that if in the States they consume vegetables, perhaps they will get a lot of benefit, but obviously the data cannot be transferred immediately to other socioeconomic and geographical conditions.
One last question. Was there an easy way that you had like a takeaway message? I don't know, if you follow this diet, you will live 4 years longer, or did you do any sort of analysis like that?
There is a possibility to give a very simple message. If you eat a Mediterranean diet, you will live 5 years more, or you will prolong your life, or...
No. No, because what we have shown is a statistical association. It is a statistical association, which is significant, highly significant, between a style, a way of eating, and a clinical events such as mortality. The association does not necessarily mean causation. So we cannot say that Mediterranean diet causes a reduction of mortality. We always say is associated with. Now, the mechanism why, or if there is a causality, I hope so, but our data cannot allow to say that.
Our spokesman will have the last word.
Thank you. So another, I think, may be difficult to answer question, because if we use statins in the right dosage and the right statin in patients with coronary artery disease, we see an effect on mortality or on cardiovascular events within few months, and this effect goes on for a long time. So have you any data that show how long do you have to switch, let's say, from a not well-performed Mediterranean diet to a well-performed to see a positive effect of this diet?
This is a very interesting question also from a research point of view, because as I mentioned before, the methodological contexts are completely different when you study statins in a randomized trial or you follow the spontaneous behavior of a population in respect, let's say, to smoking or to Mediterranean diet. So it is more difficult to analyze the question in this group. While you know that you gave statins at a certain dose for a certain period of time. But this is a question that by continuing the follow-up, perhaps we can try to answer.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.